Since he did not spare even his own son, but gave up him for us all, won't he also give us everything else? Who dares accuse us whom God has chosen for his own? No one. For God himself has given us right standing with himself. Who then will condemn us? No one. For Jesus Christ died for us and was raised to life for us. He is sitting in the place of honor at God's right hand, pleading for us. Can anything ever separate us from Christ's love? Does it mean he no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity, or are persecuted, or are hungry, or destitute, or in danger, or threatened with death? No. Despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ, who loves us. And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears of today nor our worries of tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or on the earth below, indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Thank you. important. We know we didn't have a spoken sermon today, but I hope you heard through scripture and through song the sermon today. And our God is great. Before we get back to Pastor Bruce, we'll sing one short benediction, our benediction.
Father, we've concluded thank you for the reality that we can know you, that you're approachable. We thank you for the Lord Jesus Christ, who made the God of creation and the God of all eternity real to every one of us. And we thank you for the Spirit of God that works in our hearts, who has come in to remain and to abide and to teach. And we do pray today that you would bless each of these young people, that you would see that their lives are fruitful, that they will stand firm in the faith that was once for all delivered to the saints, and that together that we'll see great progress in the coming years. We thank you for our church and for possibilities that are still here for the young man who's coming next week to see us and be seen by us. And we pray for him, we pray for the church as we respond to him and to the possibilities that you have for us. May the Lord Jesus, who looks into our hearts with love and compassion and forgiveness, be pleased with our attitudes. And we do pray that as we fellowship together around the tables today, that you would bless us, that you would lead us into an ever-deepening commitment to Christ. We thank you for Brother Bruce and for his leadership these months. And we pray that you continue to uphold him and strengthen him in this ministry. And may all of us together rejoice because we are known of you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior.